This is a story about the son of Rumi. Rumi's son was asking his father, you know Rumi, yeah? The famous Persian poet? Yeah, okay. Now his son asked him a very, very, very important question. Yes. When I read that, I thought, oh, I have to share it with you quick. You know, it's very difficult to find good story, because some story may be understandable in Persian language or in Chinese. And when it's translated into English, it's not that funny, or it's not very comprehensible, or nothing very meaningful. Probably for the Western mind, it seems strange. Rumi's son asked him, how and why is the dervish hidden? Is this done by superficial disguise? Or is there something within himself which he conceals? Why should a dervish want to hide himself? A dervish in the old time, not by name, like somebody like wear a robe and become a dervish, is different. What he means is the real enlightened master of all time, okay? The true dervish, yeah? Just like a true Buddhist, yeah? True bodhisattva, and not just by name. So why should a dervish or an enlightened being want to hide himself?
Because the master always in danger.
Oh, in danger, perhaps, yes. Okay, in the old time, maybe even more so.
Too sensitive for the material world.
Too sensitive for the material world?
Bless the world silently.
Bless the world silently. New idea, huh? Good. Can we bless the world noisily?
Protection?
Protection of himself? Uh-huh.
It's easier to work when no one knows.
Uh-huh, yes.
To test the disciples.
To test the disciple.
Only get good quality disciples who really want to find him.
Good, yes. Not too bad. Keep going. Keep going.
Maybe he's just too humble not to really think he's a teacher and let someone really go after him for help.
All right.
Why you talk about the truth, not too many people believe it.
Oh, if you tell the truth, not many people believe it. Then he don't have to hide himself. If nobody believes, then we can sound the trumpet and...
Like Jesus, when he talk about the truth,
people... You mean trouble?
Okay, yeah. Okay. Yes, yes, one of those things. Yeah, it's more or less like protection. Okay, maybe to test the disciple. Maybe to protect himself. Maybe he's humble, he doesn't want to show off. Maybe he speaks the truth and nobody understands. Okay, now let's see what else is there. The master said, master mean Rumi, huh? Rumi answering his son, he said, it might be done in any way. Some could write love poem, and people think that they mean ordinary love. I mean, the true devas could write some love poetry, and then people would think it's ordinary love anyway. The dervish may also hide his true position in the way by adopting a calling. The way, you know, the path, né? In the truth, or his position in the universe, yeah? In the way, in the Tao, yeah. What does it mean, position? Police officer or something?
He's a spiritual master.
His spiritual level, so simple. Police officer who say yes? Who is a brave one?
Yes.
You did?
Yes. Huh? Because I thought it meant that he hides himself by taking some profession.
Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. The position in the spiritual domain. The way means the spiritual domain, yeah? Yeah. The spiritual level, yeah. He hides in his position in the way. The way is written with the capital, means he's hidden. He hides his own spiritual elevation. Yeah. By adopting a calling. What does it mean, a calling?
Profession. Like a profession,
that's
of whatever
right.
The time was.
That's right, that's right. Yes. There are writers traders, businessmen, yes. There are some traders, yeah, must be the famous one. And still others follow various different outer activities. That's correct. So he might be police official. Yeah. Remember, Rama was a king, huh? Yes. Who else was something else? Who was it? Kabir was a cobbler?
Was a weaver.
A weaver. Okay.
Krishna.
Huh?
Krishna.
Krishna?
He was a cowboy.
Oh, he's a cowboy. Okay. Wow, the Texas must be proud. Who else is a famous position?
Carpenter.
Carpenter.
Who is a carpenter? Jesus was a carpenter. Wow, this, all the carpenter must be proud. Huh?
Buddha.
Buddha, what does he do?
He was a prince.
He was a prince, but not by choice. Yeah. Anyway, he forsake his profession. Yeah. Oh. Mapa is a farmer. Huh? Farmer. Tibetan master. Mapa is a master of Milarepa. He's a farmer.
Master Swan Singh, he was an engineer.
Swan Singh was an engineer. He built in road and bridges and all that, yeah. Okay, so Rumi continued telling his son, because his son asked why is the dervish hidden? Why does he want to hide? So the master say that, this may be done for the sake of defense against the shallow. Shallow means someone who has not much interest or inclination about spiritual practice, yeah? Don't understand much anyway, and don't care. Some purposely act in a manner which society might disapprove even. Like, okay, some master very enlightened, huh? But maybe he is acting like not very proper, yeah? Not the way people expect it, yes. Therefore, the society might think that he is nothing. The prophet has therefore said, God has hidden the man of greatest knowledge. Maybe the person has chosen to do that himself. Or in this case, the master say, God has hidden the man of greatest knowledge. Maybe God has made him do this and that. Or God has created the situation so that the man of greatest knowledge, mean the most enlightened person, would do this, do that, just to fool the multitude, the shallow. A device may be adopted by the followers of the way to gain peace when they might otherwise be hindered. Yeah, just some strategy they use, yeah, or some mean they use to hide himself so they can have peace to practice or to serve their purpose. Otherwise, if they really look like a master, look like what the people, the multitude, and the shallow even, expect them to be a master, what do they look like, how they behave, you know, like in the book, the way the most people imagine, then maybe any kind of people would come and bother them too much, that they have no time to truly serve the real purpose or to take care of the true followers. That's what it means. So they will use some device or some ways or some strategy to make themselves don't look like a very morally good or knowledgeable person. You know, it doesn't look like anything like you would expect from a very dignified or decent or solemn or a very wise master in any case. The master then recited some verses for the son. Ever knowing, as they hide, they seek. They're hiding, but they're seeking. Yeah? They're seeking what? God's knowledge. Yes. As they hide, they also seek. Appearing other than they are to the ordinary man. In inward light, they roam, making miracles come to pass. Yet they are really known to no one. It's very clear what the Master said there, right? Huh? Yeah. They are hiding so that they can seek the knowledge within. Hmm? They appear not the way they are, you know. What they are inside and what they appear outside is very different. Yeah, so we cannot even tell. To the ordinary man only, but maybe you are not ordinary. If you see a man hiding like that, you sure dig him out, right? Can you tell?
No.
No?
No.
No?
Not always.
Yeah, not always. It's difficult, huh? In inward light, they roam, you see? I mean, these people, even though they are hiding from the outer gaze of the public, but they are roaming inside the light. Yes. Oh, that's very clear. Making miracles come to pass even. Mm. Yet they are really known to none. Some people might think they know them. That's what it is. But really, nobody knows them. Nobody truly knows them. That's what the Master said. Not I, huh? He said. Yet they are really known to no one. Means a lot of people don't know them. Maybe they come to see them, and maybe they pay homage, maybe they give flowers and respect, but they don't truly know that person, do they?
No.
Do you? Suppose you find that person and you suspect that he is the man of the way, would you know him truly?
No.
Why no? Hmm?
Depends on the individual and your inner kind of sincerity to ask specific questions to kind of get any response from that.
Then you will know that person.
Yeah, depending on how they are in responsive to you.
Okay.
For me, it was not the word, just simply connection.
Yeah.
To me, I think that's stronger than just the word.
Uh-huh.
I can say the word, but to feel it inside, that's the really count.
You mean the intuitive feeling?
Yes.
Okay.
Maybe they don't want to reveal themselves to you.
Yes.
And only if they feel that you are ready, then they reveal themselves.
But here the Master say that really none to none. This is the thing. Nobody knows this person. So, the Master means that you cannot really know 100% of this person. You might guess, you might intuitively feel that, oh, this is an enlightened person. But to know him in depth is not possible. Yesterday you wanted to say something more.
About my experience. What I often experience is a kind of parallel of events that take place in my life. Let's say I see some lecture of you. There was this lecture about Kabir. There was a man who wanted to visit Kabir, but he was not at home. He was to a funeral. And then the man asked, the wife said he's at a funeral, and if you go there, you can find him. But the man, he never saw Kabir before. And then the man said, but how can I recognize him?
Yeah.
And then the wife of Kabir said, you can see it on his halo.
Yeah.
His white shining light
around his head, yeah.
So then the man, he went to the funeral. And when he arrived at the funeral, everybody
has light
had
around
light
his head.
Around him. So it happened to me that somebody died in that same period, and I saw that light around everybody. So this parallel between an event that takes place in my life, and then it is commented by a tape or by a book. So at one time I had a book, it's called Living Amongst the Himalaya Masters from Swami Rama.
Okay.
And there's also one story about a Swami
who is like you read there in your book, in this poem. He is throwing meat and flesh and dirt and mud to people to keep them at a distance.
Mm.
And he's sitting amongst crocodiles.
Mm.
And like this, he always want to... he doesn't
understand.
Behave in a social way.
Yes, yes.
But like it was written...
It's not like a very compassionate master, loving and cordial and polite and so.
When I read that book, the same happened, that events took place and it always coincide with the story in the book.
Uh-huh.
So the story in the book was a kind of commenting on the event.
Hi, good for you.
Maybe you can explain what's the mechanic.
You see, if you didn't read the book, or you didn't hear my lecture about Kabir with the light around his head and everybody else has the light around their head during funeral service, then if you saw that in the funeral event of your area, you wouldn't understand why. You would think you're crazy, maybe you're out of your mind, and then you might keep asking everybody else and they would think you are out of your mind. See what I mean? So it's good that you read that and then you don't question and you don't tell even people who doesn't understand anyway. Yeah. It's good for you. Hmm? The master, why do you think he throw anything to the people so that they don't go near? Why does he do that? Why couldn't they just let him come and teach them something? Huh? Why do you think he throw them out?
To keep the shallow out.
They're all shallow? All of them? He told everybody to get out, right?
He wanted to meditate and deepen his practice.
Okay.
The master didn't want to pick up their karmas.
Oh, it's not that. It's not that, maybe, no.
Maybe because he want everyone to leave him alone.
It's not that. It's just very difficult for any master at all to find peace within this world, number one. Number two. Very difficult to find anyone who is truly, very sincerely quest for enlightenment and nothing else. Either they want to heal their sickness or want some fortune, and you win the lotto, you know, or get a pretty wife, or want to bear more children, grandchildren, any kind of things. Just want to go and bug him, you know. Just want him to dispense miracle without them working. Most people, if they come to revere a saint, they flock to him in numbers, but none of them are really seeking God, seeking the supreme wisdom or liberation. They just want to go there, borrow some, you know, merit, spiritual power from the master, just to squander it for any materialistic reason. That's why most masters, they get tired.
There's also the story about a prince who wanted to visit a master who lives in a cave.
Mm.
And then all the time the guardian was keeping him away. But then after three or four times that the prince attempt to visit the master, he finally let him in the cave.
Mm.
And then he received him on the mud and stone, and they were sitting together.
Yeah.
And then the prince said, "It seems to me that you are very lonely, living here in this cave on stone and mud."
Yeah, alone and nothing there, yeah.
And alone and nothing. And then the master answered, "Yes, since you are here, I start to feel lonely."
That's correct. That is correct. It is truly like that. People come and make you feel lonely. When you're alone, you have nothing to compare, okay? And you're deep in your spiritual enjoyment. And when some come around, they just bug you and they just drag you into a kind of a lower dimension in thinking, you know, and all that. And make you feel you're dragged back into the world again, where there is comparison, high and low, and, you know, up and down and all that. And you feel lonely. You feel the loneliness of the people, of the whole world. People are often lonely. That's why they married or they have partner or friends, you know. So when they bring that into your cave, you feel also. If you're alone, you don't feel lonely. Truly, when you're alone, you feel so good, so good, so good. for the sake of others. They sacrifice their tranquility, yeah? Many other things. When you are with the multitude, it's different. Sometimes you have to even act accordingly, you know, or compromising, so that they will understand you and then slowly bring them up.
There's another story I want to tell you, because I don't understand this story.
Tell me.
It's a story about Maharishi Patanjali. And he was a very high saint. He lives maybe 5,000 years ago.
Mm?
And he had about 1,000 students. Always when seekers came to become a student, then he disguising himself like a demon.
Okay.
And then he hanging himself in the tree.
Mm-hmm.
And making them scared or make a joke.
Mm-hmm.
And then he asked them strange questions like, are you well cooked?
Mm. Yeah, I understand. Is it behave like a ghost or bat or demon? Incomprehensible. It's not like a saint, okay? So what happened?
Then at last he had 1,000 students. And always when he was teaching, he teached behind a curtain.
Mm.
And then from behind the curtain, from his head, or maybe from his body, grow 1,000 snakes.
Mm.
And the snakes, they went in front of each student.
Mm.
And then each student was taught individual by this snake.
Mm.
But there was the rule that nobody should look behind the curtain.
Mm.
And one day, he start his lesson, and then the one naughty student, he dared to look behind the curtain.
Yes.
And in an instant, all the students were burned to ashes.
It sounds like the story of Shiva. Okay, so what happened?
Then what happened was that maybe 10 minutes later, one student came. He was a little bit late, so and he found there this classroom with all these ashes.
Mm.
And then he said what happened, and Patanjali explained. Then this one student, he asked, can I continue to be your student?
Mm.
So and the moral of the story is that we are all exponents from this one student. So we are this lazy student, this slow student. The present human race came from that person.
The knowledge of the human race came from that later student, the lazy one. So why don't you understand that story? What you don't understand?
This transformation of snake in front of each student.
In the East, you know, snake is symbolic of wisdom. You see, Shiva has a lot of snakes around him, and some Buddha or some Vishnu has a lot of snakes on top of their head. Just means each student has master taught him individually, directly, you know, but from different angle. The snake means just the wisdom was imparted to the student. It's not the snake at all. They'd be scared to death. They don't need to be burned to death. They're scared to death of everybody. The whole 1,000 snake coming and poking at you all the time, imparting to you the wisdom.
But what about this curtain then?
The curtain is a symbol of that you don't truly know the real master. You are covered, you see? You learn just partially. And the true master, you don't really know. You see the master as a body, sitting here, for example. If I'm a master, that's all you see, you see? As if a curtain has drawn between you and the master. And you don't really know it's a master or not the master. What did the master truly look like inside? For the students, you don't know.
Actually, your body is already the curtain.
Yes, something like that. Hmm?
But the rule that nobody should look behind the curtain, and if one surpassed this rule, then all the students were burned to ashes.
Okay, That is, after you initiated, you're all connected, no? If one of you ever penetrated, yes, and became so enlightened, yeah, and see the real master, the burn to ashes is mean just the destroy of the ignorance, of the physical ignorance. Destroy the ego. Not naughty, just one is more advanced, you know, daring, and can become enlightened. Then everybody else get helped too, yeah? Because we all connected, okay? So after you penetrate the curtain, that means you're gone. In the old time, the master seldom talk black and white. They give you parable, yes, or example, yes. And that is something that the outside people don't know, yeah? Okay. <笑>年轻的时候还比较不好放啊，我也是这样，现在什么都放了，连住家的身份也放了，太好了，什么都放啊，平常放家庭，然后你住家，然后后来住家也放了，那个住家不好度众生，走路也不方便，要怎么走的才行啊，住家人怎么这样走路？
叫越南齁，出家人不能笑诶，笑不能露齿，笑不露齿，然后我有牙齿，怎么笑呢？笑这个样子会憋死人啊！憋的肚子会痛了，那时，你是看看就知道了。啊，要笑就笑，又哭就哭嘛，何必嘛哈？为什么不能露齿啊？嗯，那万一有一些人的牙齿长这个样子，连不笑也露出来，那个不能当和尚是吗？ 哪有分别性觉呀？是啊，有一些人呢，不笑也露出来，是不是？啊，有一些人觉得这样很可爱呢，啊，露出来跟兔子一样比较可爱。是啊，在那个欧美哈，他们就有那个传统哈，那个牙齿用长一点，露出来一点点这样，啊，笑起来那这个这样，他叽叽，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯，嗯， 有没有看他们那个明星有一些牙齿跟兔子一样啊、哦、露出来一点点。有时候哈、哦、他们花很多钱呢、啊、要把牙齿拔掉然后弄那个吐出来那个牙齿这样才好看。哎呀人的概念不一样嘛啊。啊那些人都不能当和尚啊。哎呀在欧美哈、啊、笑出来露牙齿才好看。嗯所以他们出去都牙齿弄很大。然后要长一点下来才好看这样。笑出来不笑也露出来这样觉得好看。这样观念不一样而已哈、啊。为什么不能露牙齿知道吗大概没刷好、啊。大概笑了太美了是不是谁笑出来都很可爱所以才不能笑是不是你笑笑看啊不笑看看啊不一样啊、哎、有一些人呢看起来很不怎么样他笑出来就哇好吸引人啊是不是男也是女也是、啊、大概这样不能这样笑告诉你不能露牙齿嗯露牙都没办法哈，怎么能够呢？平常我们笑从那个生出来笑到现在，然后突然当和尚就不能笑了，就怎么能够嘛？啊，顺利不起来。
谢谢 简单快乐的修行人就好了
Happy Yogi Yeah 哇 You save the planet 现在好快 Yeah 这样子谁都不能说看不到的 yeah. 我在这边也有好几个 有亮亮就来吸引人的 yeah. Be rich Go green To save the planet 现在到处都有点中文也有了 中国人不能说我不懂英文呢，哎呀，有没有？人这边也有了，要喝水的时候，人家也要看的。那风吹出来也要看的啊，看到没有哈？哎，非常不是平常的，嗯，这个有一个人他弄给我过年嘛。 还不错嘛哈，你们过来有没有什么事啊？没有，看师傅而已哈。牙齿痛也跟师傅讲，牙齿痛就去看医生嘛啊，嗯哪里？叫你笑不要露牙齿，结果你露出来才痛啊，露出来就风吹嘛。<笑> 风多然后水少了，没风水。啊，哪个风水哈有效吗？有用吗？有用，有用。有一些是生活常识嘛，比方说我们东西太多了，那到处都放在那个车库、仓库里面。有一些人哈。 他去收集那些乱七八糟，那垃圾那种哈，比方说卡通啊那些，放很多，然后全部都叠在车库里面。他的车子哈，几十万的都放给我外面，是啊，就没生活常识嘛啊。然后放了又不是说放得很好，就是很乱啊。所以那个一看了就心也乱了，不舒服。我们心不舒服，当然我们那个想法也不会通了。 然后做事就不会好，不会明白，所以这是风水不好，是这样。所以我们不用的东西就把它拿掉嘛，啊，带走那个东西不重要，拿出去给别人或是丢掉。嗯，如果不能给别人就丢掉，我卖也可以赚钱呢。Garage sale， 何必叠在哪里？很多人你去看，很多人那个车库是不是满满东西啊？他车子很贵重，都放在外面了。 <笑>晒太阳的啊，然后那些卡通的都要保护得很清楚，在车库里卡通啊，我是那个什么旧的那个鞋子啊，已经打开一半的那个<笑>鞋子，眼睛睁开在前面，嘴巴睁开那个啊，都放在那边，万一有一天需要啊那个啊坏掉了雨伞啊。 破掉的那个棉被啊，什么都不能用的，都放万一有用，都是万一有用，然后就叠在那边。车子很贵重哈，都丢在外面了。很多人都是车库满满东西，然后车都开在外面，有没有看到？是有。你们车子呢？啊？没车。啊？没有车。 没有车更好，没车不用 insurance 啊，不用那个付点钱呐、啊，哦，保险不会怕有车祸啊，没车就没车祸。<笑>现在哈、哦，他们都鼓励人家坐那个叫什么脚踏车啦，所以你们又很流行了，<笑>走路啊，脚踏车现在就很流行嘛。 所以根本不用车子，坐在山洞里面打坐就好了，好舒服啊！就不想起来了，何况要有开什么车呢？我们这边这个世界啊，绑我们太紧了嘛，男和是女都一样，嗯，绑不同的地方哈，身体也绑我们。那有时候我们不想结婚，他也让我们要结才行，呵呵真的，这个世界真的很无聊，很无聊，很痛苦，很痛苦。 谁都被他们虐待到极点，啊，男也是这样，女也是这样，结婚也是这样，没有结也是这样，不同的，不同的虐待方式。结了以后，那生小孩，要小孩又继续虐待下去。OK， 小孩就去结婚了，哦，松一口气，等一下要孙子，回来那阿妈，<笑>如果他们夫妻不好，我就搬回家，跟妈妈住，妈妈刚好轻松了，一会儿又现在又要养小孩了，哦，那么可爱，<笑>可爱，然后就被绑了，啊。 就是这样子啊，工作不完了啊，休息不了。哎呀呀，然后现在也许没有小孩，没有孙子哈，也有别的事情。现在世间荣华，这个我们跑不掉，这个不是说小孩，不是不小孩啊，有小孩我们也可以说哦，他结婚了，我不管他啊，有孙子是你小孩，你自己养。那世间荣华就没办法，谁都被那个受影响了。 世界很多毒气啊，那个原子弹的毒气，它不会跑掉呢，它还是在我们的空气流传一下，所以即使没有那么严重，跟那个刚加那个弹的时候没有那么严重，不过现在还是会轮流在世界，在空气里面。然后太阳哈也有它的有帮助，不过有它的那个伤害的地方啊。 我们很多毒气都在空气里面，又毒气多，因为现在越来越多那个车子啊，还有工厂啊，哈，然后又小了氧气，大的森林都被砍了，砍很多、啊、，Oh my God， 不想了就还不好怕。 想他们每天砍多少，我会怕坏了。怎么会能够有人破坏我们自己的家？是这样，只有一个家，一天到晚破坏，不破这边就破那边，嗯，盖很多房子，然后没人住也开，为了赚钱，为了那个税金减少，啊，然后还有什么？做什么？还有做什么？
种给猪羊吃。
哦，对对，要给动物吃。呼。 所以那个叹气越来越多，阳气越来越少，所以我们呢老了比较快，然后身体比较疲倦，嗯，那个生命很短。以前听说那个什么彭祖啊，他活到八百年哈、啊，这不是开玩笑的呢。为什么不能留呢？我们这个身体现在跟身体我们20岁的时候一模一样。 有一些根本没有什么病，比方说身体都一样哎，没什么差别。有一些又看起来很年轻，就可以留哎，可以留很久的。本来身体可以保留很久，800岁不算，8000岁也可以的，80000岁都可以的，无所谓的。本来我们身体很了不起的，它可以自己自动返老还童，对，更新啊，对的。 哎，它可以排除那个毒气哈，可以排毒那些旧的细胞，换新的。它天天做很多工作在里面，它天天都出产很多新的细胞。哎，然后每隔大概4个礼拜，再换新的，换血、换皮肤、换细胞。我们应该每个3-4个礼拜都重新再还同的呢，然后可以永久再保留。 释迦牟尼佛说：“我们能得到这个人的身体，就是很稀有，就对了。为什么他那么赞叹这个肉体？既然每个都说，肉体是很那个无常的哈，没什么的，有什么的？因为有这个身体啊，才可以修行很多啊。没有身体不好啊。天使他们没有我们这种身体，我们身体很了不起。” 因为我们可以训练呢，可以训练的飞在天空去呢。有啊，现在还有人可以飞的。即使也许飞不高，不过还可以飞一点点。这个是现在的呢，以前就可以飞呢。那个腾云驾雾不是说小说的事情，我们古代人都会做的。走在水上那些是没什么的。现在有一些喜马拉雅山的那个和尚也可以做的，我亲眼看到。 不会沉在上，他不是在那边游泳啊，不是不是，他在站在那边，是坐在那里在水上而已。 不过如果我们滑久一点，我们可以训练很多那种神通，没什么了。你想象以前那个彭祖他滑的800年，OK，我们不说几万年了，所以以前呢，我们都是称那个皇帝，圣王万岁万岁万万岁，也许有啊，没有他怎么会这样想到？ 以前是这样子啊，以前是可以留到万岁万岁万万岁的，就是我们越来越被那个污染了，身体它没办法来不及那个修理，所以我们才老才快死，以前不会死这么快，800岁、1万岁是普通的事情，中国人以前都一定有人留到万岁的，不然他怎么会想象这样子？ 从来不知道怎么会想象，那想这样子会变成说谎呢，是不是？没有这种事，你就给那个国王卧高的希望，对的，那个是细菌之罪的嘞，<笑>不可能这样子给皇帝那个卧高希望的，给他一种印象，所以一定是以前是有的，就是也许没记载，只有一个彭祖他露出来。<笑> 以前都很多那个书都被烧掉嘛，秦始皇他大概嫉妒了，他看那些万岁的人，他觉得哪里有，他那个时候大概那个打仗很疲劳了，50岁60岁已经腰酸背痛，所以他<笑>不可能有一个人留到那个800岁1万岁，所以他气嘛，气死了，<笑>把那些书都笑掉了。 我们现在那个历史记载很多东西都看不到了。师傅，火星人能活多久？火星人200年，有一些比较多，有一些比较小，200年不算，有一些人留更多。你们等着看嘛。主要就是空气好，精神好，没有太多那个。 杂念没做，竞争社会都很平安的话，那个平常的人也会更活更久了，最多可以增加20年、30年，就是我们世界太乱了，太那个疲倦了，竞争力太大，整天工作8个小时、4个小时，赚多少钱呢？没有多少，然后还要付税金呢，还要付那个保险呢。 还有这个税那个税呢，人去看朋友也要付钱，<笑>是啊，付也不一定拿到机票啊，有一些地方是这样子，这个边拿钱，这边拿钱，那边拿钱，然后你不能去，钱也不还给人家，哪有这样？这样就算公平吗？我告诉你，比方说，你去买一个东西，你去一个店，你订一个东西。 那个东西不来，人家还钱给你是吗？最少有80%哈，或是即使也好，50%也好呢，不给，钱不给，东西又拿了，哪有这样？啊，这样就说自由民主。<笑>我告诉你，这个世界好笑，真好笑，越想越好笑。 哭不出来的了，<笑>哭没有用，只好笑了，哭都没眼泪了，太疲倦了，哭不出来了。我想到你们辛苦，真的有时候我心里很酸。业障从哪里来呢？我刚生出来好好的一个娃娃，什么都没做了，越长大越有业障，奇怪，就一定是社会带来的嘛。比方说我们生出来。 吃妈妈的奶而已，那等一下就强迫吃那个鸡肉、猪肉，然后牛肉，等一下习惯了，没有那个会饿死，没有那个就是没营养了，饿死，因为我们被关这概念嘛，说我们要吃那个吃那个，不然的话没营养。肉我们本来也不吃啊，是他们强迫我们吃，然后为了这块肉被强迫吃的。 然后为了那块被强迫吃的，以后平老啊，整个辈子。如果我们从小被养着说 ，OK， 你自己种一点呢，沙拉什么在外面 种一点水果汁，水果自己拿出来自己吃就好了嘛。那真又便宜，是不是？喏，要吃猪，吃肉，吃鸡，吃牛，然后那个就，啊，你吃了，业障你，哎，吃我的肉有业障。那魔王会跟我们这样说，本来我们生出来不知道肉是什么，就被强迫，整个社会都强迫我们的父母吃，然后。 那个他的父母也强迫他吃，然后现在他强迫我们吃，然后我们如果没有那个金海五三十，又强迫我们自己的小孩吃，所以一天到晚为了吃东西哦，卖命啊！没有吃东西，哪里谁要工作呢？工作干嘛？而且要吃肉哎，很贵重的，不是说吃那块肉，我们把那个地球吃哎。 吃肉就是吃那个地球吗？所以现在地球才快没有了，为了肉。我们又不是要这样子，他们外面的那些吃肉喝酒，不是也不是他们自己要这样子，生出来没什么，等一下就被强迫了。Some
of the diseases related to meat consumption and/or production: rabies, anthrax, sleeping sickness, Q fever, norovirus, swine flu. Ebola Reston virus. Cured meats and fish increase leukemia risk in children. Antibiotic-resistant superbug infections from a strain of Staphylococcus aureus. Blue tongue disease, E. coli, Salmonella. Bird flu, mad cow disease, or Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, 90% of the population at risk. Pig's disease, or PMWS. Listeriosis, shellfish poisoning, pre-eclampsia, Campylobacter, Clostridium difficile, diseases hidden in healthy appearing livestock, some of the costs of meat eating. Infertility, eating just one serving of meat per day increases the risk of women's infertility by 32%, with additional meat consumption increasing the risk. Heart disease, over 17 million lives lost globally each year. Cost of cardiovascular disease is at least $1 trillion a year. Cancer, increased childhood cancers and adult reproductive cancers from hormones in meat. Colon rectal cancer, over 1 million new colon cancer patients diagnosed each year, more than 600,000 colon cancer related mortalities annually. In the United States alone, colon cancer treatment costs about $6.5 billion. Millions of people are newly diagnosed with other meat-related cancers every year.
Diabetes. 246 million people are affected worldwide. An estimated $174 billion spent each year on treatment in just the United States. Obesity. Worldwide, 1.6 billion adults are overweight, with 400 million more who are obese. Costs $93 billion each year for medical expenses in the United States alone. At least 2.6 million people die annually from problems related to being overweight or obese. Environmental. Uses up to 70% of clean water, pollutes most of the water bodies. Deforests the lungs of the earth, uses up to 43% of the world's cereal, uses up to 85% of the world's soy, causes world hunger and wars, 80% cause of global warming, plus more.
Some of the costs of milk consumption: cowpox from milking cows, bacterial microbes, pesticides and enzymes found in cheese derived from the inner stomach linings of other animals. Up to 80% of the calories in cheese are from pure fat. Breast, prostate and testicular cancer from hormones present in milk. Listeria and Crohn's disease. Hormones and saturated fat leads to osteoporosis, obesity, diabetes and heart disease. Linked to higher incidences of multiple sclerosis. Classified as a major allergen, lactose intolerance, plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers. For help quitting, please visit
So, 然后越长大越有业障这样子。 然后越有越胀越疲倦，越疲倦 越有越长，也不能想，然后人家做什么就弄什么，不能独立那种想法，不能自己开悟出来，没有主张，所以人很可怜啊，真的不懂而已，然后即使有师父到处去找，不过我能叫多少人呢？我不能天天叫他们，我不能去伦敦开示。 一天，然后留在那边，每天就盯着他，因为他盯到一岁，哦，也许那个时候他盯得很高兴。OK，我一定要吃书，等一下回来就一百个人盯着他看，你这不是祷告白客？<笑>他的朋友就叫他出去吃牛排，那不吃的话不行，今天不行，明天不行，后天不行，后后天就倒了。他的爸爸妈妈还催着他。 他的先生太太催着他，连续他的小孩也催着他，妈妈，你不能吃的样子，你会死掉。啊，要吃肉，比方说这样，压力很大，所以你们能够保持那个吃素的那个程度，哦，我已经很高兴了。不说你们在做什么别的事情，那吃素已经很好了。不过吃素也要干净，这个时候真的。 连我们要干净也很难了，面包也放蛋在里面干嘛？他放蛋在，不跟你讲啊？都不标出来。不标出来，因为他就放一点水，跟那个蛋在一起的，那刷在上面，为了那个面包亮亮好看，而且要脆脆的啊，所以这样子法国面包是那脆脆的面包，有时候这样要问清楚，问有时候他不讲，他也不知道。 啊，他不知道，他从那个别的地方买的嘛，啊，带回来他也不晓得，所以有时候哈，连那个冰淇淋也放蛋在里面。Oh my god！ 然后那个糖啊，也被经过牛的骨头啊等等，啊，有一些那个 brown 也会经过，除了那个不是砂糖的哈，最好不要吃砂糖了，那种。 粉粉的糖，也许还保持原味呢。我在越南没有知道他们这样弄，他们不会这样弄。我就看就是他们那个把那个什么干砍下来，然后我就用机器嘛这样脆，然后那个干的放在中间这样子，它就把它吸掉那个汁，这样然后放在一个桶子里面，然后久了以后它煮滚起来，它就变得比较硬。 有，然后有一些砂糖就撑在下面，放久一点就变一些有砂糖，也是自然的砂糖的，所以我不知道，林师傅也不会有空去研究这些事情嘛，啊，越来越知道，哦，真的太可怕，连吃糖也要有问题，哦，这种世界嘛，真的是魔，真的要把我们压得到底。 吃什么东西也要被他们围在里面了，太可怕了啊！连糖那么无辜的一个东西，一进关烤焦的那些骨头，
还有吸附作用，它会褪色。对对对对对对对，会让那个糖变得漂亮。
对，漂亮，哦，漂什么亮 ？My God， 哦，太可恶了，真的太可怕。任何东西，它就真的想把我们拉下来就对了，不给我们修行。 因为那个鬼魔，他们嫉妒我们的人啊，因为我们人是跟上帝一样的同类的，那边我们有不可思议的神通，所以才有人可以修行啊，漂在水上呢，同时可以出现好多的地方呢，就是用身体做的啊，从这个身体里面什么都有被装好的，身体里面有灯、有亮、有爱，什么都装备在里面好。 鬼魔没有这个，他不能装备这样子，所以他们嫉妒嘛。即使他把我们杀掉哈，身体拿出来看看，他也没办法把我们那种那个看不见的隐藏起来那些瓶子把拿出来用了，所以他们嫉妒就把我们压，意思说我不能用，你也不能用，是这样子。 所以鬼魔他们太惨了，太惨了，就是那个那种上帝的热色嘛，然后 捧起来想当大人啊，想当那个圣人，结果没有、没有爱心，怎么能当圣人？圣人跟鬼魔差那个地方啊，他很有智慧，就没爱心。我们人啊，圣人会有爱心，可以修行，可以去不同的那个境界。魔修怎么样都上不来的，顶多就是面见那个第三人那边站一站，看一看，流口水。所以他们嫉妒我们，那是讨厌我们，他拿不到我们那个东西啊。杀我们几片人，杀多少人也拿不出来。那种东西又不是说物质的东西。比方说，爱因斯坦的脑袋哈，跟我们脑袋看起来一样，不过他的聪明度我们拿不出来。即使我们把他的脑袋放在我们的头里面，也不会跟他一样的。有一种不同的嘛，比方说，释迦牟尼佛成佛了以后哈。有一个魔，他来把他杀掉，然后把他那个心啊、他的头啊、他的脑什么都换到他那个魔的身体里面，他也没办法跟释迦牟尼佛一样呢，无所不在、神通广大、爱心那个勃勃这个样子，了解我意思吗？拿不到，我们人都有这个能力的，都有这个释迦牟尼佛的品质，修多的什么都有的，所以可惜。所以他不让我们滑得很久就对了，所以自古以来哈，都把很多事情弄得很乱，让我们那个世界毒啊、毒气哈、困难的哈，然后把我们生活的压得很痛苦这个样子，让我们没办法滑得很久。滑久一点，我们就什么都会发达出来了，他只能流口水，然后他没办法控制我们，我们就会压他。所以他才控制我们哈，什么都做了，毒药啊、毒品啊、毒气啊，什么都做了。以前也打仗啊，炸弹什么一大堆的，把我们那个保护层、透阳层，也破掉了。以前有更好的透阳层，好久以前的啦，那个彭祖大概的时候，我是更久以前的，世界和平的嘛，哈 ，OK。就是魔那个从自古以来就想办法破坏那个人类就对了，所以他很多东西都乱七八糟跑出来了啊，病什么都有来了，然后我们不吃肉也会生病，因为他们偷偷放肉在里面，偷偷放蛋在这里，老年不能放也经过肉经过骨头漂白什么东西，恨性太强了，他那个是魔嘛，鬼也没办法叫不成，很多那个鬼魔现在也是跪降了啊，不过还有一些硬头，世界还事不完成，所以才很多麻烦。不过即使他们跪降，现在已经很晚了，很多人已经受苦了啊，很多人被混淆了，现在很多人还是混淆，然后毒气很多，连我们滑也是滑得很昏昏沉沉的，所以有时候坐一下就累了，没有工作也累了，没有吃东西就累了，吃东西也累了，啊，是这样啊，做什么都不行就对了，因为满满的空气啊，还有气氛里面已经被破坏了，很多人那个佛定的能力都压整个地球下来。所以很多人都想不通，师父在他面前讲道理这样子，对你们是很那个很明白就对了，没什么不会不懂了，他也不懂，他怀疑，不然的话习性难改，那块肉放不下，比方说这样子，不是他不想放，磨压，有一些磨压比较多，有一些磨压比较少，有一些意志力比较强，所以压压他也出来了。我一定要试试跟着师父就对了，不管了，痛苦什么我要去，有一些苦一点点那就退了嘛，所以就磨压他，压一点他就怕就退了，所以你们就算勇敢了，恭喜了哈。 然后哈，越勇敢，越吃素越明白了，越了解师父讲什么啊，哎，所以以前还了解，不过现在越来越了解，因为自己很明白嘛，开悟了啊，自己会跟自己本人那个大力量的沟通。我一直说你们还是被压太紧了，不过这样子已经很了不起了，我真的很珍惜你们了啊，即使不是肉已经很了不起了。人外面不是书也不是坏人，不修行也不是坏人，人性本善嘛，要相信这个一句话，真的性本善。我们从上帝下来，怎么性不本善呢？我们生出来小娃娃这样，哎，想杀谁，想吃什么肉酒精，没有啊，就是讲出来被一大堆已经污染了，就再污染我们。一个污染两个，两个又污染三个，三个污染四个，我们生出来就已经被包围了，我们真的游泳不出来，游不过去啊！你们能够奋斗到这样子已经很好了。
Some of the benefits of a vegetarian diet: lowers blood pressure, lowers cholesterol levels, reduces type 2 diabetes, prevents stroke conditions,reverses atherosclerosis, reduces heart disease risk 50%, reduces heart surgery risk 80%, prevents many forms of cancer, stronger immune system, increases life expectancy up to 15 years, higher IQ, saves 70% of the total cost of $40 trillion for reducing global warming, uses 4.5 times less land to grow food, conserves up to 70% clean water, saves 80% of the cleared Amazonian rainforest from animal grazing. A solution for world hunger.Free up 3.4 billion hectares of land. Free up 760 million tons of grain every year, half the world's grain supply. Consumes one-third fossil fuels of those used for meat production. Reduces pollution from untreated animal waste. Maintains cleaner air. Saves 4.5 tons of emissions per U.S. household per year. Stop 80% of global warming.Plus more.
Some of the tragic tolls of alcohol. 2.3 million alcohol-related deaths per year worldwide. Cost of alcohol-related illnesses. $186.4 billion U.S. dollars in the United States. Up to $210 to $665 billion U.S. dollars globally.
Disease.Higher amounts of alcohol increase the cancer risk. Even half a glass of wine daily increases the risk of mouth or throat cancer by 168%. Cancer of the liver, breast, colon, esophagus, rectum. Liver disease. Cardiovascular disease. Metal toxicity. Brain damage. Amnesia and dementia. Brain shrinkage.
Organ failure, heart, liver, kidneys, stomach, pancreas, eyes.
Birth defects, children afflicted by anxiety and depression, mental retardation, fetal alcohol syndrome, stunted growth, facial deformity, sudden infant death syndrome, miscarriage.
Alcohol-related violence, child abuse, 50% of cases.Violence toward loved ones, 30% of cases. Violent acts, 40 to 80% of cases. Suicides, 20 to 50% of cases. Plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers. For help quitting, please visit...
我知道在外面很痛苦哈，不是这么简单，要工作要被压力，要哇，小孩是会政府哇一大堆，谁都想拐我们就对了，即使我们爸爸妈妈是最爱我们的，也不懂，所以也压我们，让我们吃肉种少的时候，因为他的被 爸爸他爸爸妈妈一样，然后他爸爸妈妈被他爸爸的爸爸的妈妈的妈妈一样，然后他爸爸爸爸爸爸妈妈妈妈的被社会压等等啊，传下来嘛，了解吗？都很可怜，很可怜。有什么好的？
有糖吃了，是
啊。还有呢？
那是
啊，
法国的总理还有环境部长
啊，
哎，都要吃素。
哇，太好了，有看有看啊。告诉你哈，天天要看新闻了啊。因为看了才同心嘛，有没有啊？我换席的时候，你们也一起换席的，因为好新闻啊。这样我们最少有一个地方可以统一提的。每天好的新闻要看啊 ，OK， 看这样不是很高兴吗？多少人高兴举手？全部都有看新闻哈，今天那个 Supreme Master Television 新闻有看吗？
有
啊，
有
有看。每天我们报告最准的，也最有用的，算中国大陆很有进步啊。同志们那边真的很有很有开悟了啊啊，有哈啊。这个时候我们地球已经很啃了嘛哈，进到很啃气的地步。如果不合作的话，恐怕大家都亡了啊。有一些往上面没关系，有一些往下面才有麻烦啊。我们最怕是有一些会往下面走的，因为没有醒过来来不及的哈。好像有希望嘿。大家高兴快乐啊，新年快乐嘿。我看你们我就心也软软了啊，身体也柔柔了。你们打坐的情况如何？
好。
你说非常好哎，大家舒服嘿，哎，很好，我听得很好，因为以前我们多数都搭帐篷嘛啊，在那个野外打坐哈，现在这边比较好嘿，小不过好嘿 ，OK， 小这样才比较看得到师傅哈，嗯啊。就是嘛哈，大一点连望远镜也看不到，像泰国那个哈，看的师傅多少，这样那么少，看好远，用望远镜，哦，那个就是师傅嘛，有一些第一次来嘛，有没有？哈，而且又那么远呢，就不知道怎么看，这个就是师傅嘛。你确认是不是啊？你有来过是不是他？即使他有一个黑的那个美点在这边，我没有嘛哈。即使他有这边，你也看不出来。有没有好消息？来讲。
我们那一家，第二家那家店正在筹备。
哦。啊。不坏不坏，
爱家的店长跟我们就是告诉师傅现在爱家的家的生意非常好然后大家觉得就是说师傅的家生意很强旁边的那个开荤餐厅的老板呢还有都愿意到我们的爱家店里去吃饭然后跟周围的那个街区的这个民众的关系也非常的好然后就是学生因为我们那个爱家是在三所大学的周边然后学生们也特别愿意吃然后爱家还为他们推出来一个叫八五折的这种包月的这种卡然后同修在那爱家工作的同修他们可能没有机会过来但是他们那轮班呢他们在每天忙碌当中他们感觉到自己修行得非常的尽力也OK嘛爱就是看同一个方向嘛不是来抓人啊，抓也抓不了。
OK， 这样子好，他们也会得到加实力很多嘛。OK， 上帝会看得上，耶，我们就什么天堂都有看的了哈，不必跟谁夸啊，就地球再说嘛哈，以后也许别的那个荤的餐厅也会改的，变成那个素食餐厅嘛，那我们就可以退休了，啊，也可以来跟师傅共修了啊，那怎么办呢？ 忍耐几年嘛？那个听了师傅的话，就是回去以后，大胆的就是工作啊，发传单啊，想清楚就是能够救地球的这些方法，就是向社区、学校尽量的去那个。好。Very
good，谢谢。前几批到这边回去的一些师姐，那很多条那个公交车的那个两边的广告和中间公交车前面的那个灯啊。 跑动的那个灯的广告有很多人 SOS 拯救地球的，所以现在越来越多的人知道这个拯救地球吃素的消息。你们好感动啊，Very
good，
很勇敢，嗯。师傅好，我从卢乡长有朋友给我发了一个文件，就说中央政府已经发了一个红头文件，就是带红字的文件，它的那个大标题写的是。
加入素食给地球降温，就这就说明我们国家政府已经开始重视到这个消息了。哦，太好了，太好了，bravo啊！高兴。师傅，我把好消息可以讲给你听。他的公交车上做就是拯救地球的这个广告，我们在乡村里发传单，下面的我们学校的呀，我大队的呀。 他们都知道，现在就拯救地球啊，他们也非常拥护，也非常都，这个气氛非常活跃，大家都争，争着红口的，让我们贴传单了，发传单，看传单。Very
good。这就是上面下面都联合起来。很好，很好。
老师，我们有做那个就是面向同修的那个。 演讲的培训，可以大家可以在社区呀，在学校里做演讲。然后我有个朋友也是偶然碰到的，他从来不坐公交车的，他偶然一次坐公交车就看到我们那个素食救地球的广告在公交车上，他很愿意帮我，然后他能够引荐更多的人报社呀，或者其他的一些机缘，然后我们一起来做这个事情。
很好，很好。
然后我就是想，就是下一步的话，就是尽量更多的培训同修。
可以去演讲，在社区里做演讲。哦，能演讲就去嘛。那么现在自由自在，赶快去啊，冲啊！啊，哇哦，大陆现在这么自由啊！
师傅你好。
是吧？这个国务院那个参事室啊，就是一篇文章，他一个高级工程师写了一篇文章，他提了五点，其中最重要一点，他就说素食救地球。
嗯。
就是国务院的这个中国国务院。
这谁的？他是一个参事室的一个高级工程师，清华大学的。
清华大学的。OK。这个消息很鼓舞。
OK，Very good。
我在大陆的一所高校里面当老师，然后学校领导对这个环境问题也很重视。我有一个申请，就是题目叫做“环境暖化的现状和对策”，然后面向全体师生啊。这个进行演讲，那他也批准了，然后我也实施了，效果非常好。然后我还有一个选修课，它的名字叫《世界饮食新理念》。一共是 需要报两周，三天就报满了，240人。
嗯。
啊，我也准备把它好好的讲给他们，把这个情况。
嗯。
哎。
Very good. Very good.
报告师傅，现在呢也有一条公交车，我们现在正在做那个SOS 素食拯救地球的一个喷绘。
嗯。
那很快就可以上路了。
嗯。
那同时呢，还有我们选择了两条流量比较大的这个公交线路，那在它的车厢内部，那我们在座椅和两边也都在做这个 SOS 素食拯救地球的这个广告，那让更多人可以了解这个信息啊，现在已经开始在做了，三月份很快就会上路
啊。Very good. 哇哦，太好了，就这样可以公开啊。
对
对，
是吗？你给我浙江的包了，浙江的包里向有两个包子端出来的，吃什
么？哦，好棒，好棒 ，OK， bravo。
师傅，在那个庙会上，大家设立了两个素食摊位，好多同学都在那发传单，连警察都发给他，他们都要。两个素食摊位，在这公开是吃素环保救地球，标语都贴出来。
OK。你们那个弄饭馆的时候，有时候有一点点那个利息哈，要帮助地方的一些灾难什么，或是那个孤儿啊、国父什么的哈，那要经过政府，或是要自己弄都可以 ，OK？ 要报告政府说这边有没有什么，我们有一点生出来的钱哈，想贡献给国家嘛 ，OK？ 那问政府在哪里最需要的。要问哈，要尊重政府，要问，然后他就说你去某某地方，那你就去了 ，OK？ 嗯，每个月放出来一点，如果有足够的话。
我们的同学要发传单的时候啊，为了得到一个好的效果，发一张传单，有的给他一个课堂，有的给他两个课堂，这样引起他注意吧，拯救地球，吃素。
好好 ，OK， 糖就很甜了 ，OK。
我们也是发传单，另外呢，那个公交车目前有公交车上的那个，在这个广告那个素食，
哎，
吃素一天等于种树100棵，是这样的广告。
真的是这样子啊，是啊，因为算算看，然后把它放进去。等于整10棵树，对了，100树等等 ，OK， 这样太好了，
我们的同修吧，都发这个吃素的传单，一边发就是开始吃素，参加环保，一边发一边讲，而且呢，还有好多同修参加种素，而且还要就是有的公司。是开始发展这个种树的这个行业，
yeah.
他们投资参加了植树的活动，
对对对，
大家都在积极的来做这个保护地球的这个工作。
Very good， 很好了，你老了还一直种树哈，对身体健康哈，啊，让大家知道我们吃素不知怎么老的了啊 ，Very good， 很好很好。
你好，我们重庆啊，大家发传单很荣耀。每天不管是白天也好，晚上又是晚上，利用晚上的时间，这样去发去贴，拯救地球吃素。
这些同志们真的要得奖了。
还有，不管是在公交车或者是坐火车来，我们在车上也要给那些人
入方嘛。
吃素就地球怎么吃素有什么好处？我们地球现在快要不行了，要大家每一个人不分老小，都应该有这一份责任去做。
European Parliament supports reducing meat to lower greenhouse gases.
Reduce your meat consumption or stop eating meat totally.
During discussions on greenhouse gas reduction goals, the Climate Committee of the European Parliament officially recognized livestock's contribution to global warming and recommended a reduction of subsidies to the livestock industry to curb methane.
The European Parliament has adopted its own position on climate change as an institution. And as a vice president, one of the proposals I've made is in line with your own, which is that we should eat far less meat, because that's one of the major sources of greenhouse gases.
Please eat less meat and let's make taxes on meat. That's definitely one of the issues we're talking about. I'd like to tell people what the cost is of eating meat for the environment worldwide.
My name is Jens Holm. I'm a member of the European Parliament. Please, be veg, go green, save the planet.
我们准备要想开一个素食店，大家同意一起，这样想把这个素食店开起。还有，如果没有钱，那个弄饭馆就可以，那个弄便当，跟那些师姐他们做也很高兴快乐的，卖的很便宜，又还是有利息，就发便当啊，公司啊很多啊，或是学校啊。 煮了便当来一块一块酱卖给他们，也不错。哎，我告诉你们哈，做这个素食哈，最少自己不会饿死的啦。<笑>反正卖不完还会剩下给我们吃。不是还没有卖以前，我们也要吃一点嘛，所以不会怎样。
都是同学们，等于是斗的钱，拿起钱银，运气。
到公共汽车上去发，公园去发，都是那个公交车发了，马上有下公交车又到另外一个公交车去。太好了，OK。还有一些私人同学，都在做熟食，送到外面去。对对了，这样子不用那么多本钱，也不用开餐厅。
就是让他们尝一尝那个熟食，好不好吃？
好吃以后他们转了。
用口传的很多人会拿那个便当啊，会订便当。现在同学啊都动起来了，有钱的出钱，有力的出力。完了呢，经常就是大家采取不同的方式，发单子，开那个在八大院校开一些这个素食品尝会。 好多老教授都看到了非常高兴，有的都一心了，有的就是参加这个素食宣传的会，特别好。然后那个还成立一些爱心小屋，现在在好几个地方，就是都在成立爱心小屋，就是20-30平米的这样的房子，然后大家。
搞一些素食，那蒸一些包子啊什么，送给邻居啊什么的。自由自在，去哪里就去哪里，发传单就发传单，开餐厅就开餐厅，太好了啊！那边同志们真的有建心。
师傅好，还有好消息。 那个环保之声九地球吧，跟他讲课，讲完课以后呢，就是让他们在研讨，然后再给他们拿素食送给他们品尝，他们一边吃呢，一边就觉得这个素食好，然后呢，这个市政府里头那个大楼里开的，然后还照了这个电视呢，这个电视里播放一次重播一次，一天多呢。 电视，我们那边的电视里播的。
这样子。
然后还有好多同学吧，都在自己组织讲稿。然后在各个什么社区啦、什么学校啦，还有一些那个政府的那个大楼里头啊，去讲课。现在这个都在搞这事儿了。
太好了，太好了。这样子就是真正的是民主、自由还有独立什么和平的。 有什么温饱了啊，太好了。真的是理想的拿到了嘛啊，有时候理想的好讲不好做嘛，如果能做得到就是很好。
我退休呢就到处一边发传单一边讲，有的时候发点毛巾呀，发点别的小礼品呢，一边讲，周围好多老乡吧在一块儿听，就这样，这这不就地球快完了吗？这样咱们这些争论起来好多就说特别积极响应那样。
他不知道啊，
嗯，他们就特别惊讶。
是啊，有一些人真的可怜的不知道
这样一想，他们有时候这传单东西特别多，来不及那什么什么吧，看吧，我们就一边嘴说一边宣传，说一窝一窝好多人，有时候有的那个通宵吧，就开始那个自己家蒸包子，就那么品尝，就觉得哎呦，这素食挺好吃的，所以每个通宵都行动起来了，
太好了，那团结比较好工作。
这个通宵的团结特别好，而且我觉得下边老乡们呀，尤其是像那个40岁以下的这样这个老乡们吧，就表示支持的特别多，反正年轻的有也有一点不好吧，不好但是说慢慢的我们觉得慢慢宣传还是就是说积极，大伙儿都积极起来，积极宣传还是有好处的，
还有好处，一定有好处。
我刚音信一个月，然后就来到这里看你，真的万分的荣幸。
我们那块也是发传单，有那个印传单，另外那个印那个兜子发的更快一些，大伙儿更欢迎一些。另外我们那个出钱那个做在社区做大广告牌，但是我们觉得我们干的还是很慢，
好厉害，
干的很慢。
哎呀，已经很好了嘛，以前都不行，现在这样，太好了，太好了。哎呀，我替你们高兴了啊，以后大家就同一国了，就不用什么大陆、小陆、中陆什么的哈，因为以后大家全部都整个地球都会合在一起嘛，合作的意思啦啊，你国还是你的啦，没人来占啦，意思说比较自由自在，大家比较互相了解啊。以前大家都没人惯紧紧的嘛，比方说那个国家啊，很难进去嘛。进也不行，出来也不行，人家在外面养养啊养，好像懒洋洋的啊，要进去看看，为什么不让我们进来呢？啊，有时候这样子去了就打僵了，打仗。就是如果大家都开放这样，每一国都自由自在，互相了解哈，互相学习，就不会有战争了，哎。这样以后会这样子了哈，以后一定会这样嘛，会进步嘛哈，跟别的星球一样，very good。
黄子还有一个吃素的事情，
多一个
我吃素的事情，
真的，我去杭州的时候没人讲像你那样子。
我到阿拉到这个哪，到乡里下，到这个小区，到学校。
一定很好，
他说好，很好很好，
很好很好，对的对的，一定。
他说那个中央二台的那个健康访谈，这个很正式的这样的一个节目，就是孙晓梅主持的一个节目，也放了那个素食是对人体最合适的一种饮食，中央电台放的很就是电子很主流的媒体，
太好了太好了。
还有那个就是江西卫视也播放了一个节目叫联合国那个预言说80以后上海将被淹没，这个也是主流的一些媒体。
好，那你们把这些报告 Supreme Master Television 我们把它放上去啊。
我们也设计什么 proper 就是演讲的一些图啊，那个 flash 这样的，还有很多那些素食的资讯啊，包括大陆的一些什么，我刻在光碟上面，可以发给大家，扩大大家每个人都可以演讲，都可以学习怎么去演讲，然后每个人负责自己的社区，因为我们在社区做嘛，还是效果蛮好的，
Very good,
双碟
，Bravo 。我意思说，你们如果知道你们的地方哈，有某某电视啊，有播放那个素食啊，某某报纸、啊、有关心那些事情啊， 要报告 Supreme Master Television 的，让他们广播起来给大家知道，现在就是有这种风潮的。我们天天有报告说某某报纸有登啊，某某电视台有广播。
说我在巴黎来的，
嗯，
今天听到大陆的同事这样多的好消息，
嗯，
不是很高兴，
嗯，
但是我在报告时候的消息，就是在巴黎啊，
嗯，
这个礼拜天他有展览，嗯，展览是展览那些动物的。那么刚好在那个展览场对面，嗯，我们同时有造一个庭院那边，
嗯，
所有的同事有造很多的树枝，
嗯，
去那边免费送给人家去。
啊，
刚
好
从青海就
很多同事，努力在那边发传单。
啊，太棒！
大家就决心了，回家好好去干一场，就说真的。大家刚才说来了一下，全部从各个方面嘛，刚才是不是说的，
嗯，
报纸、电台，
嗯，
什么广告，
嗯，
啊。另外我们是打了这个可能有半年的一个广告，在这个最闹事的地方，
啊，
一个大屏幕，
啊，
上面就是素食环保救地球，
对，
就是肉食是全球暖化的元凶，
嗯，
还有什么，素食可以逆转心脏病啊、糖尿病，
嗯。全部都放出来，能够放多少消息就放嘛。对了，对，应该大家每个地方都弄一点点这样。
还有师傅，这次的是有很多同学，我很激动，我也很高兴。
知道知道，
我们心中都很感动，很激动，谢谢。
你好，师傅。我想要是每个地方、每个地区，或者是每个省市都有素食的点，或者是素食的社区，
嗯，
然后并且能够带动影响更多数的人吃素，
嗯，
希望能够并且带动那个农村或者是其他地区，能够推动有
对了对了，不过我也不能强迫大家嘛，他们能做什么，他们已经尽量做了呀。
希望素食能够成为一种时尚。
以后啦，以后 ，OK， 你自己先做嘛，啊，我找别人。